Heroes will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Nick and I'll find out starting in today's game between the Stephen F. Austin Lumberjacks and the Ohio State Buckeyes.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Buckeyes should be able to play a lot of bodies tonight, Nick, as they're highly favored on paper, but what are the keys for them to win?
Tonight, the keys are pretty simple. First of all, take care of the ball on offense and play aggressive perimeter defense. Next, you can't win, baby, if you don't get the glass. You must rebound. Rebounding is the key. And lastly, get out on those shooters. Challenge every shot.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. Both teams are looking to get something going here.
He's got to pass it or make a play, Brad.
There's a high screen. Jumps into the defender. Perfectly executed. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Goes up for two. In and out. Puts it up, looking for contact. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Number 30 picks up the foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He is going to the line.
Nothing but nylon, MBN.
And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. The screener takes a big-time blow setting that pick.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Goes. Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. He puts it in with contact and all. They look to get it to the inside. There they come with a double team to stop it. And the ball goes out of bounds. Trying to feed inside. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
The ball goes out of bounds. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
And the ball goes out of play. Thinks about the shot. He goes with a jump hook. They still don't score. Dumps it in. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Looking for a screen on top and got it. Can't get the shot to drop.
Look at that spacing.
With a bucket. Up and in. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Here's a double team. Shot's there if he wants it. Nice shot.
Trying to go inside.
The skip pass is picked off. The point guard with the ball. He's got a nice shot fake.
There's the trap.
He shoots from left of the circle, way off target. The point guard gets the pass. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works. There's the screen up on top.
He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if you were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
The point guard gets the ball. Number five is charged with the foul. First personal foul. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, how about this crowd? They're enjoying this close matchup, and there's nothing better than a close game during tournament time.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Number 44 with the fake.
Takes a bite on a defensive end.
Taken away.
You really need to protect the ball around these guys.
Turns it over. Number five takes the feed. Looks at a three. Off the mark.
Hey, this crowd will be ecstatic if they can get a basket.
Looking for a good shot. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Ohio State are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they've put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Steals a pass.
Coming inside.
He pump fakes. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. A double team waiting there. Here's the three ball, way off target. Number 23 takes the pass. He comes up empty. Dick, the three ball virtually non-existent tonight.
Hey, because these kids are so well coached on how to play proper zone defense, Brad. That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Number 14 with the foul. First team foul. Looking for a good shot. Number 22 fakes the shot. Jumps in.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass. Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
On the outside, looking for the foul. He drains it. And now they'll bring it up. That one, there should have been a foul called, I think.
Well, you take a look right there. I thought there was contact right on the defensive player.
He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Defender right up on the ball. Trying to draw some contact. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
On the outside, looking for contact. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show is about to start, Brad.
They'll work it around the arc. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Number 14 is feeling great out there right now.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
Got the high pick. Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. He strokes it. Off the rim and no good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important than the guy with the right there.
Yeah, that helps. Now check him out. Who would have thought? With a cheerleader. Come on.
I love the zest in the young man. Dancing with the cheerleaders. That's awesome, Brad. Inside.
On the dribble, gives it up. Shoots from outside. Way off target. From half court. He misses from downtown. At halftime, the Lumberjacks are down by 12. It's a close one, folks. What have you got, Dick, as your play of the half?
Watch here. Pounding the ball inside like you see. And this highlight will take a lot out of a team on defense. I expect to see more of the same from both teams in the second half.
And now let's get ready for the start of the second half. Stephen F. Austin is practically handing the ball over to the opposing team like it's a Christmas present or something right now, Dick.
Hey, any team would gladly receive this kind of nice gesture. I bet they're not getting anything but a mouthful of criticism from their coaching staff.
The ball goes out of play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Erin. Now they're working around the perimeter.
Great anticipation defensively. He saw that developing.
He was right there when the ball left his hand. The shooting guard receives the pass. Gave it up. He puts it up. Off the rim and no good. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Fakes a jumper.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
The point guard handles the pass. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Trying to draw the foul.
That's an 8-0 run.
Number five is seemingly at an emotional low point at this moment, Dick.
Emotionally, he needs some inspiration.
Goes up for two. In and out. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
There was no doubt about that one. Moving it around the perimeter. Number 45 in the paint. Easy one. Looking for a good shot. He takes the shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I'd say it just doesn't beat him to the basket. Not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Pulls down the board.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
He was guarding him tightly, and then he went for the steal. An unsuccessful attempt resulting in a personal foul.
If you're going for the steal, you better get it. If not, this is exactly what happens.
Here's a nice face-up down on the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face-up and then just attacked him and took it to the basket.
The shot from the baseline. Rims out. Looking to move it around the perimeter. On the outside, number 21 is fired up right now, emotional.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
Looking for a good shot. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. He shoots from the top of the circle. The Buckeyes lead by 17. Now they work it around the perimeter. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Steals the pass. There they go. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
The center receives the ball. Down he goes, and no foul call either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, had the real extension.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Gets it back out. The point guard handles the feed. Working it around the perimeter. 10 seconds showing on the shot clock. He shoots from long range. He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
From right at the circle. Off the rim and no good. for the bucket. Lays it in. And he'll kick it back outside. And the ball goes out of bounds. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Moving it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray. He drains the bucket. Move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
They get the ball down low, and he hips up with his man, and down he goes.
Hey, Brad, that's a flop. That's Mr. Flop right there. Don't call that, baby. The game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Rims out. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I think great job on it.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
The ball goes out of bounds. He's mocking the crowd. Now, that's throwing salt on the wound. The fans are definitely going to be annoyed with him.
You've got that right, Brad.
Number 33 steps in for the first time tonight.
This may or may not have been the right substitution at this point, Brad.
10 seconds to shoot. Off the rim and no good. Sweet-looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
From long range. He drains the shot.
Wow, that's worth the price of admission. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Got a nice screen. He fakes the shot. Strips him clean. Fast break opportunity here. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Picks off the pass. He lets it go. He's good for another score.
Hands in his face. Anytime now, boys.
Pushes it up. With a deep pass. Gave it up.
Spacing.
Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. He tries the three. He tries the buzzer beater. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The State Farm drive of the game.
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up, up, and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
Ohio State is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their